What's up, future pros? I was looking for a Delver deck for Standard, and I got a list from a friend. And I'm going to be honest, I do not know what some of these cards are even doing. I don't think I've ever seen some of these cards, because I don't really draft too often these days. So some of these cards are, like, I wouldn't play this card in Limited. But let's see how all of this works together. I was looking for a Delver deck, which this is. It's a four Delver deck with eight of the flip lands, eight of the double face cards, which I like. I think that's a good way to flip Delver. Like, basically, like, you know, a third of your mana base, a little bit more, is instants that flip Delver, so that makes sense. I like that there are white creatures that are cheap. Like the Maw, for example, like playing two spells a turn shouldn't be a big deal. Then you have Delver as a creature. This puts a counter on something. You can flash it back. Okay. Something with Learn. That's an instant. This is a lesson. Choose a non-land card name. Opponents can't cast spells with that name. Okay. Choose target non-land permanent. Then it can't attack or block. Okay. So it's like a one-turn pacifism. Exile something, they get a 3-2. Wow, the lessons are not very good. Chilling Trap, -4/-0. Give a wizard, draw a card. What the hell? Okay. So there's a card that I like that says, tap enchanted creature. Oh, it has to be red. Okay, I thought this was red or green. Okay. Then that's not as good as I thought. Also, it's not an instant or sorcery, I suppose. Okay, so that doesn't work. Well, I'll play it as it is. A lot of lessons. Tap something, gain hexproof. Cast instant or sorcery, target creature you control has base power 2. Fading Hope, I can get behind that. That works in this format where you can bounce like red tokens and stuff. And Lumenser. Well, alright, let's just, you know, let's just see what happens. Let's give it a try. Traditional, standard, ranked. I was trying to play one best of one game with it. And then I forgot that I even queued. After 20 minutes, I was still queuing. And that was one of those bugs where you, if you leave Arena open for a while and then you try to queue up a game, it just, I think it just sees you as disconnected. So you just never actually queue into anything. So if that's been happening to you, just restart Arena and that should fix it. Let's see what this deck is capable of. I'm not expecting too much. You know, if we go 2-1, that'd be really, really nice. If we go 1-2, I'm not going to be mad. You know, you don't always have to play Anderson Field tapped unless you control two or more lands. No way. Two tap lands? What the hell? I mean, I guess I have to keep. It's a fast hand. I don't like that I'm starting with two tap lands, but I mean, looks, this is really good with all these cards. Now the island go. This is gonna attack for more than the Monk, right? If I draw a land. Divide by 0. Well, this deck is like full of draft cards, basically. Well, it's gonna really suck if they have a bird spell. I mean, what can I do? Please don't murder my guy. Disruption. That's okay. We have it's a flashback spell, so it's not even that bad. I don't even know if that's worth playing disruption on. It saves them one damage every turn. I guess it's not that bad. Like, if they just want to try to buy some time, I mean that's probably reasonable. This gives it only hexproof, or yeah. Okay, so they play that line, that makes sense. I get to play double courage probably. And then hold up the approach. That seems good. Is there anything on 4 mana I would like to divide? Not really. And I need to put as much pressure as possible, so I guess I can start with this thing. They could play Klasm. I'll pump this guy twice. They could play Synderklasm, so I'll try to make my guys bigger than that. Yeah, this guy, I was like, yeah, I don't know about Lumenancer. Like, it seems much more like a, you know, like a historic card maybe, or like maybe even like a modern card where you can play Mutagenic Growth and these kind of cards. But that's like some pretty fast block. Because this was my turn 4. Yeah, if they only have one burn spell and I can protect my guy, then they might as well be dead next turn. I like that you get to play some like really aggressive one drops. I was looking at a different version yesterday. It was a snow list with red. It was blue red, and the list played the ascended spirit, something like that. 1 mana 2/2 that you get to make better if you just invest some snow mana into it, and that looked okay. But I didn't really love that. The snow mana base doesn't allow you to play this. I mean, I don't really know what can happen here. But let's start with this. We probably play a burn spell. I give my guy hexproof. Okay, never mind, not even that. I mean, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Hello and good luck. Fading Hope. I do have Fading Hope, but we're going to say no. Game's hexproof. Wow, that was impressive for the first game. Not bad. Was, you know, decent blue red deck. They got all the stuff that they need. I think that was one of the world's versions, because I think I've seen one with 4 and I expected windfalls. God's way. What are we board in? I think these counter spells are probably pretty decent. +1 for a creature in your party. Like, this countering a windfall would be really cool. 3 mana is a lot for the divide. Hexproof things really, oh, this is gonna be bad. Unless they have the egg, in which case, I don't really mind the egg though. Like, clearly my creatures can be bigger than the egg and just attack through it. So I think I can just board out all of these and bring in the counters. I like the hexproof thing against them. They have a lot of burn. That's a lesson, lesson, lesson. Fateful Absence. I don't think we need that really. Wait, how do I only have 57 cards? What else did I board out? Oh, I only brought in one. Okay, it only brings in one. I thought it brought up the full playset. Okay, now it makes more sense. Yep, let's go. Katsune. No. No.
Right. Somebody.
It's a pup. Somebody's bored. Blue, white, no one drop. Oh yeah, we do have one drop. Okay. Reasonable. Pretty reasonable hand. Is this really another tapped land? What the hell? I understand you need like some number of duels, but I don't think you need that many. Gladly pay 3 life here. What does this do? Whenever you cast, copy an instant sorcery spell, creatures you control get +1/+1 on end of turn. Okay, that's reasonable. Basically, I need to find an answer for burning down the house, or like, hopefully they don't have cyndoplasm and they're not gonna owe me with the 5-mana sweeper. I don't think I can really attack. I think I'm playing Clarion Spirit. Kind of rough not being able to attack with your one drop. This card is not that great. I like Lumimancer because you can really grow that. Like, grow a lot, but this is... I don't know if like a white 1-1 creature wouldn't just be better that gets like a bonus if you do something. I don't know if there is something, but this doesn't seem all that great. So we go white. I think we want to go... Actually, maybe I save Spirit for next turn. To guarantee, yeah, I'll just do this, I guess. Yeah, I think this makes more sense. Because with Spirit next turn, I guarantee getting the token. And I think going wide is better than like trying to pump my team, because they're going to be killing my creatures, so I probably won't have that many creatures in play. This needs to be something that attacks. Is my first impression of the card. So get white from this, Spirit, Lumimancer, and still don't get to attack. Played a one drop, dealt zero damage. Can't say that makes me too excited. There has to be a decent white one drop. Like, what do the other decks get to play? They get to play the Disturb guy. Raptor. Okay, well, let's play consider. Hexproof. Hexproof's pretty bad. Put that card in graveyard, yes. I think I need to draw a counterspell here. Oh, that's rough. Should have played my one drop right away to guarantee getting a token. I don't think I can play around the sweeper. Like, if I sandbag a Lumancer, like I'm sandbagging a 0-1, like, is that really gonna help me do something? I'll just go for it here. I should have not played my... Actually, no, it's fine. It's fine this way. Like, maybe they're going to be scared of, like, you know, a Jawari Disruption or something. Although, they probably just have to play into it anyways. Super. Oh. Oh. I think you should cut some of the losses in the sideboard and add some, like, real magic cards. Like, just, you know, have, like, a negate in the sideboard or something. That would go a long way. Like, I don't think you need, like, double of some of those lessons. It doesn't seem that necessary. I'll hold control just to bluff that I have something. Vrr. 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 A smoldering egg. Well, that is not a sweeper. I could really draw a spell. I could really use drawing a spell here. Otherwise, I have 3-0. What the hell? Tycoon Hazard, oh my god. Yeah, well, that card doesn't do anything. Oh, they didn't have a fifth land after playing Deluge? Oh, they chose to play this instead of... Hmm. I think I'm flooding out a little bit. Like, six lands is probably not what you're supposed to draw in your first working cards. But yeah, at the same time, like, these cards were just, you know, something else. Flashback is really nice, though. Like, I wonder if there's a different flashback card you can play. Like, something cheap, something... Some blue flashback card, maybe. Hanger number two. A flashback card. Well, that is decent. This is flying, right? So bump that. And limit's gonna be 4 power. Or I can, yeah, I think I'm bumping this. I guess maybe it was better to just double pump the spirit, because then I get a 4-power creature and that can actually attack. Yeah, I should have double pumped the spirit, that would have been better. I think I saved this in my hand, no reason to really play it. Unless I drop two running restoration, or like a land and a restoration, or like two running lands, I guess. No, it has to be one land, one restoration for me, for this to be bad to keep it. So far, the flashback spells have been great. Symmetry Sage, a little bit less. Basically, like, the best card in the deck is the card so far. Divide by zero, that's not for the guy. Oh, now they get to shoot my spirit. Oh, they put both? Oof. Yeah, I think I'm dead. The fact that they also gain 2 life from this is a little too much. Yeah, I'm just gonna... Actually, well, I don't need to concede just yet, but I'm pretty sure I'm dead. Oh, they have a bound spell too. Monk is really nice too. That's a good one drop. That's a good one drop. Because you do keep playing a lot of spells, so this is growing out of proportions really quickly. Yeah, I'll just concede here. And there's literally no way I can win against the 2 dragons. They're just gonna keep shooting my creatures every turn. There's no reason to. I really keep playing there. 4, 8, 10, 12, something like 20 lands. Okay, so drawing 6 lands was that early was a little unfortunate, I think. Fear Spirit 0. I still don't think I want Fading Hope. I didn't really care about the 0-4 too much. I have this. I can tap it. That's fine. I would like to play first. Oh my god, that's a very baneful mana base. I don't even know if I keep this. I don't think I do. I mean, I have two, like, they just think this doesn't deal any damage. 4 lands is already too much. I think I probably mulligan this. Oh my god, the tap lands again. Throw this back, and then I get blue, white, this thing. Yeah. I get to start with Delver. Yeah, Delver's better than Monk. Alright, flip. Flip my human wizard. Oh, let's go. Counter learn. Oh, yeah. That's exactly what we want. So I go Monk. Yeah, Emeria Skull into Monk. Yep. And take 3. No big deal. Just a turn 1 Delver. And that flipped right away. I have a Force Spike on steroids, sort of. Oh, love this card. I would like to make my What kind of burn spells do they have? I think I want to pump the Monk, probably. Just pumps it twice. Alright, what do we get? I think we get this, right? Then I draw a lot of cards. Don't think I want to exile anything. I don't think I want to do that. Yeah, let's draw some cards. Attack for 4, no big deal. Hopefully they had 4 spike they were not able to use. Okay, that was nice. That was a nice turn. I think I will play the defense on it, because then I can play my teachings next. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I don't want to, like, you know, finish the game while holding cards that I wasn't able to use. So I think it's better to just use. Ooh, wow. Is this just lethal? What the hell? What? Are we going to get a turn 4 kill? That makes this guy 4/7. Yeah, I think that's lethal. Can they have something? They can have the shock. Okay, well, they don't have anything. Wow, we got a turn 4 kill. Not bad at all. I mean, I had the best possible draw pretty much thanks to Delver flipping on turn 2 and then having the one mana counter. That was nice. That was impressive. That was impressive. Let me just do some real quick research on flashback cards and one drop creatures though. So let's take a look on White Weenie. Plays Raptor Chaplain. Oh, you can play Usher of the Fold. I think that's probably better than the blue one drop. Just attacks for 2 every turn without really, you know, you needing to draw to do any work. I mean, it's a flyer. I get that it's a flyer. Might be better, but Look at the top three. Oh, okay, that's not good. Investigate. Okay, also not good. Gain two. No. No. So that's it. Okay, got it. I think I will try Usher instead of Symmetry Sage, because that card was really tilting. What about the mana base? 4, 8, 10, 12. So this way I have how many blue and white sources turn one? 4, 6, I know, 4, 8, 9, 9 blue untapped sources. I think this just needs to go. I mean, I get it. Like, you need colored sources too. But I think it would be just better as a plains and an island. Like, you can't run six tap lands in this deck. What other lands are there you can play? How do you get non-basic lands? Okay. Wow, that's it. Just no fixing. I think I will just add two basics. Hopefully that's not crazy, but let's see. Normally the way around this would be to just, you know, play more things that cost turn one, like white mana instead of blue, or all turn one blue one drops, and then you would be able to play more untapped blue sources, but this deck kind of just wants both untapped white and untapped blue at the same time. I'm gonna keep this. That's a good creature to have as just the only creature if you are planning on playing a bunch of spells afterwards. Delver though. Okay, I can get behind Delver turn one. I don't get to play this turn two, but I mean Delver turn one is nice. What are they getting priority for? Is this moderate with shocks? Don't tell me this is moderate with shocks. What? They burn my face? What? That is the most aggressive play I've ever seen. I guess they were trying to look for to find second land. What the hell is this deck? Oh yeah, reveal. You bet. Oh, I really hope I punish this person for not burning my insectile aberration. Oh no, they have multiple shocks down. Well, I think I have to play this. I don't think I can sandbag that. Boros Burn, All Monitor. Okay. Oh yeah, they were definitely looking for the second line. Okay, that makes more sense then. This deck's great. If this deck got a little bit more help, like another blue, you know, flashback card, like blue tap a creature, flashback, blue tap, that'd be insane though. That'd be insane for limited, I think. Well, we're gonna go wide, and I think that is gonna be good enough. I'll just kill them with the flyers. They probably bring my the bigger creatures, but the flyers are just gonna give them very likely. Yeah, what's the thing here? It's a turn one shock your face. The only better way to do this is if you just go main phase, you know, mountain, shock you, bass. Just assert dominance. Faithful Absence could be okay. -4/-0 against Hull Monitor dub deck. Probably not. Do I just not sideboard? I mean, I kind of like all the cards. The bump spells are great. Both the voice and the courage are great. Consider, I think you have to have that in your deck. Fading Hope is going to be probably better than the removal spells. Just costs one mana, I think that's better. Maybe I don't need the tap your creature thing, but Hexproof is nice, Hexproof is good. So it's only really divide by zero or removal. I think divide. No, removal is probably better, is it? This is expensive. Can you target your creature with Faithful Absence? Faithful Absence MTG. You can, okay. So worst case scenario, I can use it in my own thing. That's a really nice draw. That's a good draw. We'll keep this. Yeah, this is kind of like the perfect one drop for this deck, because like it has power already. It's not a zero power creature, and it just keeps growing because you do keep casting two spells a turn very often. All right, play the monk. I don't think I want to trade this, right? No, no way. Best card in the deck, no big deal. I'm gonna need a... Actually, I could just play a Nerescroll, but I don't think I need to take the damage here. I can just do blue and then next turn take three. Yeah. Let's attack first, see what happens. Clarion Spirit Pass. I guess I could have also played this tap so I don't take damage and just play one of the one drops and next turn play Clarion Spirit with another card to guarantee getting a token. But this is also fine. I mean, maybe I don't even need to take three next turn actually. Let's go. I wonder if it's going to get Faithful Absence or something. Cinderclasm, that's what they have. What is that doing in their deck? Oh my god, that actually owns me here really badly. What the hell? Oof, that's rough. So it clears the entire board. It's already triggered, right? When you cast a second. They already let that resolve. Yeah, I don't think I can do anything. I mean, they only have one card, so it's not that bad, I guess. Den of the Bugbear, that is a good one, though. Can I get a creature? I think I'll actually just bounce the land this turn, just so that they don't get a free token. rather than playing the Consider. Because it's extremely likely they activate this attack, make a token. And if I use the Fading Hope now to... Wow, okay, well then that's fine. You can choose whatever you want. This has to be the worst deck you can play Spellbinder against. Because I literally everything I have is one or two mana, so it doesn't really make a big difference. Faithful Absence. Well, I don't really want that. I kind of wish that was a... Yeah, that was the bounce thing now. Let's put that in the graveyard. Elder of Secrets. Oh, let's do that, I guess. Make it bigger. We can play Environmental Sciences, get another land. Maybe I shouldn't have played Emeria. At some point I could have actually cast it. If they have more cards than you, draw two, but they can just play out the land. I mean, I could just play it next turn if they don't play out their hand. I could play this on the line. I think I would just rather draw two cards next turn. Make my Delver bigger again, sure. And we can make Spellbinder not be able to attack or block. Or I take Sciences, find an island, but then if I draw a land, this spell is not going to do anything. I could just hope that I don't draw a land. I mean, I don't have that many in my deck. Oh, plus this is a decent combo together. Yeah, I'll get a signs here. Get an island. Getting lands out of my deck is also nice because that means this is more likely to flip. I mean, not by too much, but, you know, decent amount. Oh, wow, that's a big attack. That is a big swing. I wonder if I have to just trade for the Stormseeker here, otherwise I'm just kind of dying. But maybe, yeah, I guess my guy could just be better. If it flips, it's just going to be bigger than their creatures, so maybe I can just go for that. Okay, well, that sucks. Reveal? Yeah, we're going to reveal that. So I can bounce one of their creatures and I can draw two. That's pretty reasonable. So bounce the Stormseeker. Put you on the bottom and then draw two cards. Delver of Secrets, but I don't have blue mana. I don't think I can attack. Now I need to find an Emeria to make 2/4s. That's fine. Oh my god, they can make it 4 power. No, that was literally the best draw. I think I have to block and just draw Emeria next turn. I don't really think I have many other options. Because if I don't block, I'm dying. I have to trade. That sucks. Emeria or bust. I don't think this is good enough. Also, it goes in the... Not in the graveyard. Okay, that's a good chance. kind of just throwing cards away here, which is not very good, but let's the power of Cinderplasm, I suppose. Fateful Absence, that's great. I love that they kill my Delver here. That's the best that could have really happened to me. Because it wasn't really doing anything, and now I can find... Okay, Clarence Spirit is also nice. That is decent here. If I draw another spell, that gives me another blocker. Oh, no, that's not a card I want to play in my turn! Oof. I mean, I have to play it. I just have to play it. I have to throw it away. Yeah, that's the problem of playing this deck. Like, some of the cards you're playing are just too bad. Like, they're way too situational. Like, this is never going to be a tier one deck. I mean, you can try to, you know, have some fun with it on the ladder, but I wouldn't recommend bringing it to a tournament. Unless they, you know, print something like a Brainstorm or... What was the 3-mana 2/2 Hexproof guy that gave you an Angel when you attack? Like, that was a really good piece of the Delver deck before when it was in Standard. I have to play something next turn because otherwise this flips, so... Let's hope I'm drawing a spell. Basically, I'm going to make my game plan around drawing the... Make two angels thing. Choose blockers. Well, I could trade for it. Don't really have a better plan against it, so let's just trade. Oh, they have a shock of Fateful Absence. Okay. See what I get. Okay, we have a chance now. I could make the land and pump it though, and I am forced into trading for one of the angels, so I'm definitely not out of the woods just yet. I mean, not even close. The problem is that the average card in my deck that I'm drawing is incredibly bad. What if I don't block? Then I attack? No, that doesn't work right. No, no way. Does that have vigilance? No. But learning is nice. Learning is nice. You don't really get much though, right? I don't really get to get a creature or anything. I mean, let's see what we get. This is gonna flip back, so I can bump the Usher actually. It's probably better. Teachings does nothing. So the only thing I can do is get this. Wow, that is... I really wish there was like a way to get a creature. So I can make this guy unable to... No, I make this guy unable to attack or block. And then if they want to... Attack with this, I get to trade, so that's okay, yeah. Okay, this one. This works, this flips back. Hopefully they don't draw creatures so that they wouldn't move in haste. Then if they want to trade, that's cool, and then we would be... Okay, well, that's unfortunate. Fading Hope. Problem is, if I don't play anything on my turn, this is gonna flip, and then it gives Trample, which is bad. Attack with Usher, make a token. Let them, they probably pump, what, they pump Spellbinder, then I die. No, I don't die. Still trade, I don't get to, I don't die. Then I, no. And there is no really good way out of this. If I bounce something, that doesn't help me either. I can bounce this, attack with, no. Okay. I mean, I can try to survive, but I'm literally just chomping their creatures and I didn't really get to draw into anything anyways. I don't know about this thing. If you control a wizard. Oh, the O2 was probably a wizard that I cut from the deck. I mean, this card is really bad though. I think rather than this, I probably have the bounce spells. On the plague, to be more aggressive. I don't really want to turn their creatures into treasures or clues, rather. What is this? The game three, match two? Match two, yeah. So we're up a match so far. Not that bad. Pretty good. The first match was really cool. Like, getting to play against slow decks is really nice. Like, I think that's really, it's kind of what you want to play against. Like, if people play a lot of Izzet with, you know, all these expensive cards, and that's really nice. Hello, opponent. Please, maybe submit your deck. Can we maybe get a match going? Hello? Nice. Thanks for answering my prayers. Yeah, we're not going to be keeping that one. Turn one, tap duel. Need to see it. I have to throw away a blue card. I think it's consider. Just hope I flip my Delvers. Fireblade Charger, you got it. Delver of Secrets. Lumimancer. I could upkeep Fading Hope if I really wanted to flip my Delver, but I think I'll just never do that. That's fine. Oh, you got it. Not what I wanted. I could draw cards next turn. It's actually kind of nice. I think I'm getting this thing. And then I'm bouncing their 2/2 before combat, and then I'm drawing two cards with this. That's okay. That seems good. They're definitely gonna have more than four cards than me, I think. If they play land, one drop, aspirant, then they still have four. So I guess I would need to draw a non-land, and them to have exactly this set of cards. Am I bouncing it right now? I think I'm bouncing it. I don't really want that thing to keep growing. Oh, please don't send your plasma me. That would be rough. Oh, they're thinking of playing it for one? Maybe I could have let them resolve and just let them play another creature and see what happens. Oh,
Oh yeah, they definitely have a Cinderclasm.
We ditch that and just hope to flip the Delvers. And also hope that they don't have a Cinderclasm. Okay, okay, that works. That's fine. All right, let's go. Let's go, Delvers. Come on. Oh my god. I really needed that. Really, really, really needed that. Yikes. Please don't have a shock. No, I was supposed to draw two here. No way. Wait, I'm drawing two anyway? What the hell? Oh, draw three if they have four. Okay. And I didn't draw a land. Oh, man. I think I have to attack with both. They want to trade for the Esper, and that's okay. I need to be as aggressive as possible. Yikes. But yeah, that's what you, I mean, that's what you can expect. Like, we don't really have, you know, brainstorms or ways to really control our draws. What the hell? Well, I guess that resolves. I think I'm taking the damage probably. Can do this and this. It's gonna be a 2/2. At least I can block the land. Wow, I think I had like one of the best possible draws, although I did have to start with a tap land. That was really bad. If that was an island, I think I would have been a lot faster, although it probably wouldn't have mattered. Like they had like the perfect answers. They had three removal spells, like two cheap creatures. They still have three cards in hand. Yeah, I can't really win this game. This deck is a real grind. Like you're trying to you're literally trying to win with a draft deck against you know standard playable Magic cards. So it's really not that easy. Oh, is that? That's the double face card, right? They're playing Shatterskull Smashing? No? Well, that's fine. Oh, they can make the land bigger. That would actually be a good play here, I think, because I can't really block it. But yeah, I think they realized that. What do I want to keep the monk, I think. I think I bounce the charger. I can't really attack. I have to keep the monk back then. I really need the second counter on this, so I'll just do it this way. Probably the sciences, because I need lands to crack this. And gaining some life is not that bad here. Oh wow, that's a good card to draw. Okay, we might be doing it, depending on, I mean, they have four cards, but that was a good card to draw for sure. What is this? Trample of what? Vigilance, trample, lifelink, indestructible? What the hell? So I just take it. That doesn't seem like the greatest card against a deck with four Fading Hopes and, you know, cards like that. Okay, crack my thing, see what we get. Basically, we're on a Fading Hope or bust because I need to bounce that next turn. Oh, I guess I'll just crack it now. That is not a Fading Hope. So I need to chump block it literally with five creatures so that I don't kill it, but I don't die. I can't kill it as indestructible, but. Whew. So let's say they put two counters on it. It's a 5/5. So I need, if I put a counter on the token, counter on another token, make a token that still doesn't do it. So if I go Lumimancer, doesn't really matter. It's gonna give me a 1/1 to 4, but then I have to block with the Usher. Sure. Oh, they just attack? Is this an instant? I thought that might happen. Wait, why didn't they do it for two? After damage, like they could just let damage resolve, Fireblade Charge takes one, then you play Cineplasm. And, well, I guess it doesn't matter, they get to kill me anyways, but put it in the graveyard. Let's see if they figure it out how to play their card with Flashback. Wait, why didn't I get a. Oh, I already played a spell before that, okay. Yep, you got it. All right, we're 1/1. That was way too much cheap removal. Like, playing as Shocks is not what you're hoping for when you submit this deck. I hope you guys appreciate me trying to struggle here with a draft deck against, you know, standard playable Magic cards. Play first, Delver, four lands already. I think we have Delver, we have to keep. Like, that's a reasonable hand to keep. Can bounce your own creature too. USA, USA. Okay. keep the mana up. If they play the 2-mana 3-3, I'll probably bounce it. Try to set the top of my library up for Delver Flip. White Source passed the turn. I could have waited for with this until my turn. Oh yeah, that would have been better. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. I messed up. I should just reveal the look at Delver card first. And then if it's a bad card, then I play Consider and just mill it away. Yeah, that was bad. That was bad. That was definitely bad. That was definitely bad. Because now I don't get to do anything. Like, I would have flipped Delver. Then I would... Yeah, that was not good. I mean, the fact that we drew two lands in a row also didn't help. But what are you going to do? Is this lifelink? No, vigilance. I think I have to keep this for the... for the rent token. Oh, can't really do anything here. That's fine. All right, upkeep, bounce your token. Put that on the bottom. Reveal, okay, now we're doing something. Pump my Delver, pretty sure. I could just make this guy not be able to attack or block, and then I just do a lot of damage this turn. I can also just draw two with teachings. It's not that bad. Not that bad. They chump. Is it better to deal six more damage or play teaching? So, if I do this and even play this, that makes it 8, 12, because 6. 6 is not 0, though. I think I go for the teaching. Draw two cards is good enough here. Alright, do some attacking. They very likely chump, I think. Save them some life, yep. If I didn't mess up the early turns, that would have been so much better for Delver. Because I would have dealt two more damage with the Lomancer, like my Delver would have flipped. Like if I just did it correctly, that would have been so much better. Oh my god, perfect draw. I got rewarded for playing bad. I'll take it. We'll take it. Bounce the big token. Land is okay, right? Because I get to play a Marios Call, like that's pretty good. At the same time, I can just put lands at the bottom, and then whatever I draw is going to be a good card. Although not really, because I can draw into like a Lumimancer. So yeah, I think I'll just keep the land. I can tap the... I don't need to tap it though. Yeah, it doesn't make sense to tap it really. Kill Bren, tag them. Wait, what the hell? They're blocked. Oh, they didn't block. Okay, I thought they would just block my creature for some reason. Boast is only when this attacks, right? If this creature attacked. Okay, so yeah, let's pass. Sure. Oh wow, they can screw my scry now. Yeah, they figured it out, and you have to search, but that's okay. I mean, it was just a land. I need the second. Oh wow, I drew all my basics. No way. What? Oh, what luck is that? We drew all four basics already. What? Holy crap, you gotta be kidding me. That is unlucky. Well, I could have done this now. Oh, it doesn't matter. I think it's better to keep it anyways, because I can just play two cards in one turn for the Limancer. Wow, that's so unlucky. What the hell? What the hell? That is so unlucky. Like the sequence of plays. What? Yeah, I'm dead. Yeah, I can't win. Okay. I wonder if I would have been able to win if I just played correctly though. I think maybe it was just my fault. Like if I just wait for this for the Delver trigger, then I could put like land in the graveyard instead of drawing it. I would have dealt more damage with the Lodomancer. Then at some point I could have just used this to just maybe push enough damage to kill them. So I think that was just my fault. My bad. Fading Hope is good. I think the tap your creature thing is not good enough. This is definitely good because they have a lot of known creatures. What are the bad cards? Divide by zero seems okay. I could just cut consider. But that doesn't seem... I guess I could cut this. It's expensive. It doesn't bounce a Vren token, which is really important. I just don't like the card, I don't know. Yeah, keep. This card has been really bad. Like, basically just never does anything. But I guess it's also because we just never really have that many creatures in play. I guess I get to play this. It's probably gonna be good this game, though. Looks pretty reasonable. It's not legendary, is it? No. Okay. Okay. Okay, well, this start is nice. Probably play like Essica's Chariot next year, though. So we'll see. Spellbinder, okay. Well, that doesn't do anything. Can I kill them if I draw another spell? Like a tap spell? That would have certainly killed them. Well, wait, I can play two spells anyway because I get the thing from this. Oh yeah, I get to get another probation in my hand. I'm pretty sure they're dead. Yep, not gonna attack or block, my friend. And you're gonna take, what is it, 17? Then 14, 17, okay. No, more than that. Take 20 damage, no big deal. Okay. Light Scribe was good this game. It's earned its spot. Now, do I want to change my deck on the draw? Probably not. Still not a big fan of this. I could just have fewer defenses. a Dust Counter Varen and Dust Counter Chariot. Like, those guys are going to be in their deck for sure. Chariot, Varen, Theodore Retrieve, like, maybe Doomscar. Oh, what a grind. All right, give me a Delver and just flip it on turn two. All I'm asking for. And two lands. I want two lands to go with it. Okay. She have asked for untap lands, but I'll take it. I'll take it. It's actually really awkward what to do with this hand, because if I play this on blue, then I don't have anything to play on turn two. So I think maybe I just start with this. I do, yeah. I'm not going to be able to flip Delver right away, but I think it's better to do it this way. Because I need to put this on white. It's also unclear to me if I shouldn't maybe have played Clarion Spirit here. Oh, they have Faithful Absence, that's what they got. Sure, you can choose from one of my 35 one mana cards. Ooh, baby, let's go. So, now what? Play Clarion Spirit Pass? No, play Double Lumimancer Pass. And then next turn, I bounce this, attack for 1,000,000 damage. I am not gonna... maybe trading them off is not the worst. So I still keep to, I get to keep pushing damage through. Yeah, I'll attack. I shouldn't have played these first, obviously, but... Oh wait, no, I should have, because that bumps the monk, so it's still better to do it. But maybe I should have just played Clarion Spirit here, just so I can go wide with the tokens. Like, the tokens are going to be hard to beat for them, I think. Sure. Nice, okay. Yeah, I should have played this last turn, and then now I would have had so many tokens. That was a mistake. I wouldn't have pumped the monk though, so that would have been different. A lot of triggers. I only get one token though, right? No, two tokens. That's fine. Oh yeah, that's a good card. That is a good card to draw. There's the Faithful Absence, okay. We still attack with everything? I don't know if I attack with the Spirit, because making flyers is pretty good here. Probably not, right? Yeah, that doesn't really change much. Wait. Like, if I attack with it, they very likely trade. I don't think I want that trade to happen. Make a token. I bounce the token. Pump my stuff. That's good enough. That has to be on the spirit, right? Because then, okay, let's see, how are they gonna block? This is gonna be force. If I actually, maybe it's better to play it on the flyer, because then 2, 4, 6. If they block, let's say they block one spirit, one Lumimancer, then they're taking 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so in that case, I think it's still the flyer. And then they trade for double spirit. I mean, it's better to do it on the spirit, because then they don't really have good blocks. Sure. I don't care about Vren, do I? You know what? When you're not killing them, just kill the Planeswalker. Vren, player. Like, there could be some weird thing happening where they, like, go plus one, that gives them four lands, they play another Vren, then put all the lands into play, that triggers Failure to Retreat a million times. Yeah, that is exactly what could have happened. I mean, I think I still win with the Flyers, but that could have definitely screwed me over. Nice! Let's go! 2-1! We actually grinded two victories. This deck is much better than it looks, but some of the games are certainly a lot harder to win if you don't flip your Delver on turn 2, or, you know, if you don't get that early advantage. And, like, it is much harder to get those advantages when your deck has to play four duels that come into play tapped, when you're playing some, like, literal draft cards. But it was fun. I mean, if you're looking for a Delver deck, like, this has been one of the best Delver decks I've seen so far, for sure. The other decks always had, like, some problems. I mean, this deck does too, but it worked out pretty well. I like the white. I really like the white in the deck. I like that this lets you go wide, makes a lot of tokens. That's good with the Lightscribe. Homestead cards has been insane. I think that's the best card in the deck. You have a pretty high chance of flipping Delver, right? Like, how many? This, Consider, Hope, Approach, Divide by Zero, and the Lands, and the Guardian Voice, the Guiding Voice. So you have 4, 8, 12, 20, 28 cards. You're almost 50% of Flipper Delver. That's pretty good. Pretty good on any given turn. Plus you make it, like, yeah, you're basically like a little bit than 50%, because you also, it's a little bit less because it's not 30, and then you get some scry effects from, like, Fading Hope and stuff, so it is just about 50%, I think, to flip your Delver, all things considered. Yeah, that's pretty good. Thanks for watching. Make sure you check out channelfireblood.com. I'll make a big highlight about this. Doesn't really going to have a sideboard guide, but, I mean, there is not really the main cards to sideboard. And make sure you check out channelfireball.com/madness, which is going to be all the cool giveaways this month, which they're running to celebrate the opening of the marketplace. And there's a lot of really cool giveaways. Black Lotus, Charizard, Flesh and Blood stuff. Just, you know, check it out. And all you need to do is just purchase something on the marketplace. I think every $10 you spend gets you an entry. If you want to get that Black Lotus, you better go buy something. You can also use my code, JUZA. I don't know if that makes you more likely to win or something, but you can try it and see what happens. So thanks a lot for watching. I will see you guys next time.